Dark money spending by outside groups continues to be prevalent in Oklahoma politics, and it could accelerate even more with the upcoming presidential primaries and general election in 2024. To learn more about its influence, I spoke with political reporter Keaton Ross with our content partners at Oklahoma Watch.
Keaton, let's start with a working definition of what dark money is.
Election spending by politically affiliated nonprofits that don't always disclose their donors. They're allowed to support or oppose a candidate as long as they're not coordinating with a campaign. And in recent years, over the past several years, we've seen that spending really accelerate and sort of bombard people around election time.
And again, that's coordinating in quotes, right?
Yeah, that can be a little loose definition for sure.
Keaton, you've discovered the money that was spent by outside groups in 2023 actually rivals the amount spent by the candidates themselves. Now, is that typical?
In 2023, we saw that outside groups spent about $2.3 million. The candidates spent around $2.9 million. That's sort of becoming the norm in our elections, is seeing these outside groups rivaling what the candidates are spending, trying to get their message across and getting their preferred candidate elected or issue across the finish line.
You mentioned issues in addition to candidates. What issue attracted the most outside money in 2023?
And that issue was State Question 820, of course, which proposed legalizing recreational marijuana and streamlining the expungement of some marijuana-related expenses that appeared on the ballot in March and was ultimately rejected.
Did most of the money go for passage and so they lost out, or the other way around?
A lot of criminal justice reform groups, both locally and nationally, were funding the Yes campaign. Ultimately, we saw that question get rejected by a pretty sound margin. I believe over 60% of voters rejected the question. So there was a lot of money spent for Yes, but it wasn't enough to get it across the finish line.
Keaton Ross with Oklahoma Watch. In November, Governor Sitz signed an executive order called the Campaign Finance and Election Threats Task Force. What is that, and what does it hope to accomplish?
It's essentially a group of state officials and appointees from the governor and legislative leaders that will evaluate Oklahoma's election system and campaign finance rules and make recommendations ahead of the 2024 legislative session, which is set to begin in early February. And it will be interesting to watch what they propose and if any lawmakers take that up in the form of a bill.
Governor Stitt is opposed to this dark money influence. You mentioned the gubernatorial race last year. How much money was spent on that, and how did it break down between what was spent for Stitt and for challenger Joy Hoffmeister?
It can be pretty difficult to pinpoint like an exact total of spending, but certainly tens of millions of dollars were spent on that race, and television ads, billboards, radio ads, all that. There was some against Joy Hoffmeister as well, but the majority of it was opposing Governor Stitt, and it was in the tens of millions of dollar range.
Looking ahead to another very contentious issue right now is abortion here in Oklahoma. Do we expect dark money to influence that issue going forward?
Certainly, if there is some kind of an initiative proposed that ends up reaching the ballot, that would certainly open the door to groups to come in and support or oppose the issue, just like recreational marijuana. That would certainly be something you'd expect, is a lot of money poured into that race and not all of it coming from Oklahoma residents or Oklahoma organizations, for sure.
In terms of Democrats and Republicans, do both groups oppose, support dark money? How does that break down?
It really is one of those things where you probably won't have a candidate that comes out and says that, hey, I love dark money. You know, there are probably advocates on both sides of reform, Democrat and Republican. Maybe not one of those issues that falls evenly along a party line.
In other words, they'll say they don't like it, but they'll probably take it. Keaton Ross with Oklahoma Watch, thank you so much for your time.
All right. Thank you.